I praise Allah and I humbly ask Allah Ta'ala to raise the rank of Prophet Muhammad and protect his nation from that which he fears for it. Thereafter, Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran, Afillahi shak. The verse means, there is no doubt in the existence of Allah. The person who is sane, the one whom Allah Ta'ala has given proper comprehension and proper thinking, knows that this universe has without a doubt a creator who brought this universe from non-existence into existence. And this person knows that this universe did not come to existence by coincidence, as some atheists say. And he knows that it is intellectually impossible for God who created this universe to be like it. Hence, if the person were to think with his mind properly and to look at himself, he would know that he did not exist at one time and now he exists, and that he was in a different state than he is now. And the thing which did not exist and then started existing is in need of one who created it. Also, the thing that develops from one state to another is in need of one who created this development in him, because the sound mind necessitates that it is impossible for a thing to create itself. Hence, it is not permissible to say that this universe created itself, or to say that Allah created himself. We seek refuge with Allah from such sayings. Allah is eternal with no beginning to his existence. He is everlasting with no end to his existence. He does not cease to exist, and Allah does not change. He does not develop, because Allah Ta'ala said in the Quran, وَلَمْ يَكُلْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٍ. The verse means, nothing resembles Allah. The creations develop. The person comes out from his mother's womb, not being able to walk, not being able to talk, not being able to chew the food. Then he starts becoming strong, and after that he changing from having been strong to being weak. The person changes, and everything that changes is in need of one who specified it with that change, who created it, who brought it from the state of non-existence into the state of existence, and this creator is Allah. And the sound mind necessitates also that it is not possible for the creator who created the human to resemble humans. Hence, it is not permissible intellectually for the creator to have a shape or a form or a picture. And it is not permissible for the creator to be attributed with attributes of the creation, such as sitting, movement, ascension or descent, figure, form or shape. All these are intellectually impossible to be attributed to Allah. Hence, if a thought comes to your mind telling you who created Allah, say, Allah exists and he has no beginning to his existence. So he has no creator. He is the creator and he is not created. One says about a created thing, who created it? And the answer is Allah. Allah said in the Quran, قُلِ اللَّهُ خَالِقُ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. The verse means, Allah is the creator of everything. I ask Allah Ta'ala to keep us steadfast to this right creed and to protect us.